Twitter search, 6 easy steps to get great search results. We all want to see things that are relevant to us in our social media feeds, right? We want to see what other people are posting on topics that are interesting to us. We definitely want to be able to engage with other people who have similar interests. But how are you going to do that when your feed, especially your Twitter feed, is all filled up with random posts and random people? It seems like a jumbled mess sometimes, right? What you need is a method that can cut through all of that and leave behind just the things you want to see. And that means you need Twitter search. Have you ever used the search feature on your Twitter account? If you haven't, then this is a good time to check it out for yourself. It's actually really simple to use and it gives you a whole lot more control over what you're seeing at any given time. When you're really interested in those cat videos, you can find them. When you're wondering what's going on with the latest celebrity craze, you can find that too. All you have to do is come up with what you want to look for and type it into the search bar. A Twitter search is just like using a search engine, except you're checking out the tweets that people have made or the tags that they've used in those tweets. You're going to search a specific keyword or set of keywords, or a specific hashtag, or mention or anything you want. Then, you can scan through the results that Twitter gives you. It really is just that simple. But of course, you need to know what you're searching. Even if you know what Twitter search is, just what's so special about it? Why are you going to want to conduct searches at all? Well, there are a few reasons that you might want to consider searching rather than just scrolling through your feed. And no matter which one applies to you, you're going to appreciate getting through social media your way, every day. See more relatable content. First up, you're going to see content that's more relevant to you. When you normally scroll through your feed, you're going to see anything and everything that's been tweeted, retweeted, liked or commented on by anyone that you follow. That could be a whole lot of stuff that's not really relevant to you at all. What that means is you're scrolling through content that you don't want to see or don't care to see just so you can get to a few things that you really would be interested in. See content from the people you want. Sometimes, you just want to see content from specific people or people who post in specific categories. When that happens, you can absolutely get better results by using Twitter search. You just pick the content that you want to see and search it. Then you don't have to weed through anything in order to see that content. The only things you're going to get are those that are from the specific people or categories that you want. That's definitely going to make it easier for you. Cut down the time. If you don't want to spend hours scrolling through Twitter just to see a few specific things that you're interested in or just to reach out to the people that you want to, searching is a great way to help. You can search for what you want to see, and that means you're going to have those results right at the top. From there, you can take a quick scroll through, engage with whatever you want, and then log right back off. It's that simple and easy, and you don't get sucked down the rabbit hole of scrolling endlessly. Increase the engagement. You want to be able to communicate with people who are relevant to you. Whether that's your friends and family or your biggest fans or people who don't even know you but you want them to. You want to be able to reach out to those people, and when you search for the right kind of content and information, that's exactly what's going to happen. You'll be able to see the things that matter and immediately respond to them in whatever way you want. Then you can move on to the next relevant content. Before you know it, you're going to be improving and increasing your fan base. If you want to conduct a basic search, you can do it really easily. All you have to do is click the little magnifying glass at the top of your screen and type in whatever it is you're looking for. You'll get all kinds of results because there are millions of posts made to Twitter every day. If you're looking for the diversion, you're not going to have any problem at all getting it with a standard search. But what if you're trying to find something a little more streamlined? 1. Think about what it is that you want to find. Is it people talking about hair trends? Is it people who want to go eco-friendly? Maybe it's people who need advice with parenting. No matter what it is, you need to know what you're looking for before you even get started. 2. Make up a list of different keywords that are related to your topic. If you're looking for people who are into sports, you might try searching your favorite team. Or you might search a specific game or match that just happened. Those things are going to bring up results of other people who are talking about that thing. 3. Figure out what doesn't matter. Think about the things that are related to the words you came up with, but not in the right way. This is where you want to be careful about the difference between kids as another word for human children and kids meaning baby goats, and other similar words. You may want to exclude certain things, and that means creating a second list. 4. Create your ideal search. Now is where you want to match up the word you want to search with the words that you don't want included in that search. With as many posts as people make on Twitter every single hour, you definitely shouldn't have a problem finding plenty of things to scroll through. That means, whether you're looking for your own interest or for a business-related purpose, you can spend your time sorting through. 5. Respond to what you find. Even if you're just looking for your own personal interest, it's important to actually engage with the things that you find in your search. The more you engage, the more you're going to see similar things in your feed going forward, and that means less time searching. If you're working on searches for business purposes, you're going to want to engage so they know who you are and they come looking for you next time. Improving your search process. Now, with Twitter, you're going to have a whole lot of tweets to sort through and you're going to have no problem finding something to look at. But you might want to streamline the process a little bit more. Maybe you're not interested in looking at all of the results right now. Or maybe you don't want to have to conduct that same search over and over again. Well, if either of those sound like you, then you're going to be looking for some additional options, right? You want to make sure you're getting the results without all the work for yourself. One of the best ways you can get just that is by using Twilert.com. This is a service that gives you all the features you get from Twitter search and then some. Rather than conducting each search, one at a time, every single day, you can just set the system up to do it for you. That means you set the search that you want to conduct one time and it repeats that search as frequently as you want it to. That's going to save you a whole lot of time and it's going to make things a lot easier on you. But that's not the only great thing. You're also going to get an email that lets you know who has mentioned the specific words or tags that you selected. That way, you don't even have to go into your Twitter account or into your Twilert account until you get that email. From there, you'll be able to do whatever you want with the results, though you should be engaging. The system is going to do all of the hard work for you, and before you know it, you're going to have a whole lot more feedback, more fans, and more time to spend cultivating them as well. Of course, there are other search tools that you can use if you want to improve your Twitter game. One of these is Chirp City, which is great if you're looking for tweets that are posted within a specific area. If your business or your page is targeted to a specific geographic location, this system is really going to help you find what people in that area are talking about, which gives you a better chance of appealing to those people. Plus, you already have something in common because you're located in the same area. Search.twitter.com is another one that lets you look up what people are talking about the most. If you're flexible on your topic and you just want to know what's popular right now, this is the way to go. you'll be able to get a whole bunch of results and you can start weighing in on the hottest topics or start talking about them yourself. That's bound to get you more engagement because the more popular a topic is, the better the chance that someone is searching for it at the time that you're going to be posting. Twitter Fall also lets you know about the newest and hottest topics. All you have to do is connect your Twitter account and it will give you live updates on the topics and hottest keywords that are being used at that very time. It's definitely going to be a simple process to use and you just have to keep watching to see what's going big. You don't get specific old tweets this way, but knowing what people want to talk about right now means that you can target those topics or you can search for them through some of your other methods to comment on them. Wrapping it up. When it comes down to it, you definitely want to be using the Twitter search features that are available, no matter what kind of account you have. If you're looking for something interesting for you to engage in personally, you'll be able to find it easier through all the chaos. If you're looking for something that's relevant to your business account, you're going to want this type of search so that you can stay on topic and make sure you're not wasting the social media time that you do have. Whether you decide to go with Twilert.com or you decide to try out one of the other top search features, you're definitely going to be better off than you would be by trying to go at it alone. After all, you want to make sure you're engaging with the right audience and that you're getting attention from the people who are actually interested in you. How are you going to do that if you're spending all your time scrolling through a never-ending feed of content that's just not relevant or important to you?